Just one, let's go with the basic operators. Okay, as I think you might be knowing it, right? So let's start from list. So what exactly are lists? How would you define it? Anyone? What we say as a list?
Collection of values or objects.
Values or objects? Anything else? List is a data type, right? So how do we define it? Just a very simple line if you can define in single words. All right. So tell me
Sequence.
sequence. Someone has written something like you see. Similar to array but have different data types. Yeah. So this similar to array but have different data types can have a name as heterogeneous. Right? This can have a name as a heterogeneous type. Okay. Better. We can say list is having a heterogeneous elements. It can hold some heterogeneous elements, right? It's a data type which can hold some heterogeneous elements and are mutable. Basically, mutable in the sense you can say as like you can change the elements, you can replace some things, right? Like this. Okay, so let's see all the functions in the list. So the list we start up with the append, then clear, copy, count, extend, index, insert, pop, remove, reverse, and sort. All these functions are there for the list. Okay. Now let's go through quickly, right? So if I say that I have a list of elements, or let's go with the practical situations, like if I have a list of numbers, even numbers. So I'll say as even. Alright, so I have like list of even numbers. Wait. Now in this, if I want to add the next three even numbers after 10. Right? So what I can do is I can add one by one in the way that we're using append function to add something. Right? Even number dot add. If I say sorry, append. If I want to write 12. We're adding it 12. And the even number would be giving me 12. So append adds the value to the last of your list. Okay. Now what if I want to add the next three in a very one time? So I'd be using the function of the extent, right? It would be doing the same thing but would be taking multiple elements at a time, right? So even number dot extent. And then would be writing as 14, 16, and 18. Okay. Then the even number and the results as 14, 16, and 18. Okay. Right? You'd be having things over there. And the next, again, as the same thing, in the last, you'd be getting all the elements. Right? So that is of the append and extend. Now, if you want to write again the elements like the next two elements as like oh if I say till 20 if we are going so 20 would be the last even number after 18 if we go with the 2 to 20 right so if I want to add that 20 in the beginning right so you might be aware of the indexings and the slicings okay so we will be giving it in the beginning right so that is in the first index so the very first index in the Python starts from 0 right. So now, what is the index with? The very first index would be even if I say even underscore number of the 0. So that is 2 right now. Okay, that is 2. Yeah. So here, what you can do is we'll be using a function of insert. Right? So 20 would be there. So what we'll do is, insert, add 0, and what you need to insert is 20. Okay. So see, 20 would be there in the first one, and it would be basically shifted, right? So complete things are there right now in the list. Now if you need to clear something, that is, you need to remove one by one and all, you'll need to remove up the things. So you would be using three different functions, that is clear, pop, remove. Okay? Now, so, someone is there, this minute. Yeah, accept it. Okay, so if I want to remove the 12th, like if I want to remove this element 12, that we will say given number dot remove 12. Even number would be having all the things and the 12th would be removed. Now if I want to remove the last element, for the last element there is a function called as pop, which automatically removes the last element from in data type, right? In the case of dictionary, it goes with the elements. Okay, that is a different thing. So even number dot pop, okay, like that. So automatically your last element 18 would be removed, see, and then you can go with the even number, and then you can find 22 4 6 8 10 14 and 16, right? Now with the clear function, if you want to clear up your list, you can go with even underscore of number, and then you can write clear function, and then you can see your even number, which will be a clear list, that is completely blank list. Okay. Okay. After this, if you want to again delete this completely, so nothing is there, so this is an unwanted space, you can say I'm taking in the Python, right? This would be having any locations. So of this even number, what is the location if you want to see it there? So this is the location which is being under kept, right? So not is in your any of the, you can say as any of the values, right? Because it's having anything empty spaces. Okay, so someone has written, can you please share your screen? I think I've done it. You can rejoin if it is having any problems. You please leave and rejoin, it would help you. Okay. So I can just delete this even number. Now even number will be giving an error, that is name is not defined. Okay. Alright, next. So these are the function of the list. With the same things, like if I say the list of a company, like IBM, Google, two of them, right? Or let's say Microsoft. So if I print it, CO, so I'll see of the three elements, right? So I can go for index, how many elements are there total? So CO dot count. Now if I want to count three, how many IBM are there? So you know, one is there, right? So if I say CO dot append IBM, the duplications can be done, right? And if I again count right now, find it to be 2. Okay, now what is the index number of IBM? Would be giving you 0, right? Because only the first element would be giving you the index number. But the learning should be learning in the numpy, like if I'm going with import numpy snp, and there we go with we'll be having this difference. If you go there you'll be getting two values, that is in the first place and in the second place, in third place, whatever you say, right? So in two places we are having this values index. Okay, that is a basic different thing we'll be learning in the NumPy sector. That's what it is. Okay, so in the list we find it has to be the very first index and the count. Okay, and in the strings you need you'll be getting a function called as find event. Okay, so there also you'll be getting the same things. If you write something wrong, you'll be getting -1 for there, right? That is the output over with the strings you'll be learning it. Okay, all right, so going ahead.
Sir.
Yeah.
So what is count mean?
Count basically returns you the number of elements, individual counts, like IBM is there for two times, see, 1 and 2. So it is returning you 2. Say if okay. I say co dot append and I say it to be good. CO dot count of Google, if I say, try getting it 2. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Alright, like that. Okay, moving on. Now, with the things, which function is being left? Let me check. Copy and reverse and sorting. Sorry. So, if this CO is there, if I want to make a copy of this, I'll say CD is equals to CO dot copy. That's it. So, CD gives you a copy of that element. Alright. Okay. After that, if I want to reverse this list, I can use using the indexing of -1 even. This reverse would be giving other things. Otherwise, I can go with cd dot reverse and then again looking to the cd, the same things. Okay, so cd is completely the same thing. What if there is original things are not be changed, right? You need to again reverse it. You can go with the cd of :: -1. That is basically having the start and the stop in the range of negative elements. Okay, so that is different thing, ranging, workings and all we'll be discussing. Okay, all right. So this is a list, basically all the things there is done in the list. Okay, so now let's go with the strings. Just a minute. Okay, so in these strings, what are strings if we discuss? Anything inside, inscribed inside the quotes, right? Single quote, double quote, or the triple quotes, all right? So we say it has to be the strings. Okay, just a minute, I'm coming.
Sir, can you explain that double conal part there, like where you put -1?
right, mute it. Okay. Okay. So strings have got some of the directories that we'll go to str. Okay. So here there are a lot of functions. I'm not going to go with all the functions. Please mute the mic. Someone has on it. Please mute it. Okay. Because it affects the recording. Okay, so we'll be going with some of the functions with the string, right? So, not going with the very simplest functions like lower, upper and all, okay? The very normal difference between the lower and caseful, do you know? Like, if there is a function like, if I say a string as difference, okay? So, it is a lower functions, obviously. If I say lower, you'll be getting the same results, right? Or if I go with the lower cases, you'll be getting the same things, right? If I make it something like this, okay? And then lower. Giving the same results and difference. Case 4. Again, giving you the same results. So can you tell me the difference between this different of the lower and the different of the case fold? Anyone can tell me quickly. Both are giving the same results. Now, why we use two different functions then? See, in the lower one, it returns your copy of a string in lower cases, okay? But in the caseful, what happens, you get a version, right? You get a caseless comparison version, basically, you can say. Right, when you are comparing things, when we are taking as an input, when we are comparing up the things, we use this caseful. Because everything there is done inside the lower case, and you need not to change everything in the lower or in the upper, you can just use the caseful function to find other things. Okay, and if you want to swap up the cases, there you can use the same word. Like if I'm having a W is equals to a word, so there I can write as W dot case fold, right? So I can find things. So then swap cases. So like this. Smaller will be in capital, capital will be in smaller. Like if I change the things, it will be confused. See? Smaller in the small channel. Okay. Now string has got something like, how do you know, like if we email IDs and all, when you sign up in any of the, like let's talk about the Gmail IDs, okay? So if you are signing in a Gmail ID, how do the Gmail portal get to know, right, exactly if you are entering the correct Gmail or not? Do they check every time of the things or not, right? So let's say if your Gmail ID is something around Henry Rock, okay? Henry Rock at the rate of gmail.com. If this is the Gmail ID, let's say, okay? Now, if the user is trying to enter with this Gmail ID, and if the user is giving Henry, if user is trying to come with Henry Rock at the rate of some readyfmail.com. So will it give the permission or not? How do it actually check? Using the last domain, right? Or even sometimes when you make your email ID, have you find that you always don't need to write at the rate of Gmail? Because you can just go with this Henry Rock, right? With your username. So basically that is your username. And but every time we used to write at the rate of this is because it's habit of writing. Okay, so what you can do there is basically we'll use this function of split. So if, not if only, if from here in the complete Gmail, if I want to look your username, then what I'll do is I'll be just copying it. And let's say this is C equals to this. Right, so I'll say C dot split with that the rate and return with the 0. So this is your username. Okay. So what is the domain you are using? What is the domain? Right? So that would be done with, this is the domain in which we are working. okay? So if this is equals to gmail.com, then only you are going to get the entry and the working through there. Then the passwords and all procedure starts, okay? But if only there is a mistake, then you'd be getting it out, right? Yeah. So split plays a very important role. Like if you are uploading something in your drives and or in your college portals, and you have been required to only upload the PDFs, not the docs and all, right? So you have then some extensions over there. Just a minute. So like if I say, if I say we have some extensions and we do have like PDF and different format like dot or HTML, not HTML, okay, so these two formats are there. And if the user is uploading something in a format of like it is uploading as resume dot in the format of DOCX, so will it be an acceptable format or not? How do we define? So we'll say if this is in, so this will be using the split and would be done using the dots, and then the negative would be there inside the extension. So if it comes to only your file, then will be uploaded. So it is false. Obviously, things would not be coming there. Okay? Yeah. Like this, it works, basically. Okay? So this is how the string functions work. Okay. Next, we are going in the tuples. There are a lot of things that to be discussed in the strings. You can go with. If you have doubts, you can ask it. Okay? Tuples, in the tuples, you have only two functions, basically, index and count. That's it. Because here, you cannot add elements here, you cannot delete elements over there, right? So that is the only purpose you can do with tuples. Like if I say d is equals to, and you can make the first brackets to there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like this, right? And there is something wrong. Yeah. So this is your tuple. Now you can make a tuple with a very single element, right? Like f is equals to 3, comma, that is a single element. So like if I say d plus f would be done. If I say d minus f would not be done because there is no such operation for that. So plus would be done with a tuple, only with a tuple, that's it. Right? So you can do only with the tuple and the tuple, that's it. Nothing else. Okay, so that is it for the tuples. Alright, let's going up with the sets. That has got interesting things. The sets, you cannot duplicate the elements, okay? The very first thing. And this is the working of the Instagram usernames also. How do we find the things over there too? Right? So let's say if we have a set here, two sets, like 1, 2, 3, and 4. And I have B as 3, 4, 5, and 6. If I say A dot add of B. Oh, sorry. So these are the functions of this, right? So you can do A dot update of B. That's a different thing. The two sets are there, right? Now, if we need to find the uncommon elements, what we're doing? What will we do basically there? So A dot symmetric difference with the B, and you get the result as 1, 2, 5, 6 are the uncommon elements with the A and with the B too. If you want to know the common elements in A and B, we'll be taking it as A and B, B and A. So you find 3 and 4 are the common elements. Or that is basically the intersection. And 4. Here, what do you find? Right? Now you want to know the difference in the A with respect to B. and in B with respect to A. 1, 2, 5 and 6. So in set A we have difference of A, 1 and 2, and set B we have difference of 5 and 6. So we can find it using the difference functions also. Like this too. Right? You can go like this also. Okay. Next is the function of updations, like symmetric precedence, update, then your union, right? Combining all the elements A dot A union B, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this. Okay. So completely different things are there in the sets. See, it would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 3, 4 gets to manage itself and you get only one occurrence over there, right? So A dot union of B, like this, okay? And you can find, you can add the elements using like this, A dot add with B, same things. So add of B would not be there, like you can go with the B. Instead of add, you can go with the update. Refine A, refine all the things over there. Okay? Like that. So if you want to add single element, you can go with the add. Like in the list. Let's say 7. 8, whatever you want. You see, the things will be done there. Okay? Now. So how to remove the things from here? We'll say A dot pop. Removing one. A dot pop. Removing two. Right? Here. Now, here, in the A, sorry, in the sets, there is a function called as discard and remove. So, if I say that I want to remove three, so it is done right now. Okay? It is done. 4, 5, 6, and 8. Now, if I say A dot discard three, it is not done, but still no error is being provided. Why? Because the discard function works as like if there is something, it will remove, but if it is not there, it will not do anything. It will not raise any errors. But with the same thing, if you do with the remove, it will give you that the key error, element not present. Okay, but if the element is present, discard would delete it. That is a different thing. Okay, see, 5, 6, 8. Okay, so that is the thing in the set. Okay, then subsets and all would be very easy. Like if I say now A and B, if I compare and I see the elements over there. So you see 5, 6, 8 and 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so if I say that B is a subset of A, then it would be false. If I say A is a subset of B, it would be subset now attribute of set, is would be there. So it is false, right? Complete elements of both the sets are not there in any one, right? So what I can do is A dot discard B 8. So it would be A as 5 and 6. Now I can write A dot subset of B. Again, it has been messed out. So it is now true. That is completely elements of A is being present in the B. That's the same. The reverse we can write is B dot is superset of A. That is true. Okay. Now, going ahead with the dictionaries. Now, it has got some key and value pairs where you can go with the things, right? So, let's say if you are like going with the marks, and we'll make it as like physics, okay? Will be some results, okay? Chemistry, mathematics. Okay. Now if I say which has got the maximum marks, so we'll find the max of this marks. We hit physics, right? Obviously now. Go to Lewis, into print. So, how anyone can tell how we are going to get it? Not callable, why? Okay. Key would be marks dot get here. Yeah. Where is the error going up? Expected at least one, yeah, obviously. Max of your marks and then your keys would be values. That would be the thing, so it is not working. Where we are getting the errors, anyone tell? Some small error we are going to get, marks.
So get argument should get, you should get one argument.
Should keep you the things. Not exactly like this. You can give it like. Keys would be having a get function, right? So where exactly the mistake is coming. Marks of the max of is your dictionary of your sorry, max of your marks. Yeah. And it should be keys. And the keys are not giving it. Here we are making mistakes. T would be the marks dot get. I think this parenthesis would be not there. Let me see. Yes, parenthesis was making a mistake. Okay, so you can find using the get function, right? Because get functions actually give you the values of your keys. Like if I say marks dot get, again, like if inside the function you need to write, like if I say physics, you'll be getting the marks of that, right? So you need to write the get function to find out the things. All right, so parenthesis would not be there. That's the problem. Okay, all right, after this. You can apply loops for finding up your things inside your key, inside a dictionary if you want to find up the things over there. So you can use loops over there to find the things. Okay. To get the values. Okay. then the items. Okay? Like that. So if I say there to add a different value, so what I'll do is marks. Okay, then I'll be saying like, let's say CS. So CS value would be something like, let's say if I write CS is equals to some values, okay, like this. So as soon as I see my marks, I will be having a different key that is equals to CS, where you can find the things over there, right? So dictionary has got a lot of methods for using the copy even, right? So things will be there. Then set default methods are there. So a lot of methods are there. Nested dictionaries are also there to find the things, right? Inside one, you can make a lot of dictionaries, okay? And then you can use some small programs even to make a infinite loop dictionary, right? So, and you can set a finite also, right? So, let me see where it is. Marks don't care. We have made 1, 2, 3. Okay, 4 is there. Right. So, if I make loop over there for I in marks dot their keys, if I print I, you'll be getting all the keys of this, right? The same thing if I say in the I, if you want to find I of marks. So this minute marks is having, sorry, i.keys is there for I and marks of I. So you're getting the results here, right? The same things can also be done in using the marks dot items. Can go with print I. Same things inside the tuples, okay? So these are the things in the dictionaries what you can do. Right now with the dictionaries you can create some Excel sheets and even a lot of things more, right? Let's say it's the same things if I have created it here, like now it's the same if I create it with more functions, with more of the vectors, with more of the list and all like that. So with that we can do is like let's say if we have some subjects like maths, physics, chemistry, okay, and we have some marks over there, let's say marks of A, marks of B, marks of C, okay. So with this you can make a dictionary even to understand things, okay? Now someone has written marks of this all values equals to marks of values, max value equals to max of all values, and then print the max. Yeah, that can be done, but if the things can be done in a single line, why to change the other things? See, it's better like inside the max marks, we get equals to max, very easy. Actually, I was making a mistake in the parentheses. Now you can make things as results or as you, whatever you say, right? So subjects would be equals to, subjects can be given as sub, okay? And then the student's name A would be given as A. B could be given as B. C could be given as C, like that. Have we done this? Okay, now I'm importing something to you see how things works. Very simple, with the sense of dictionary, how you can make the things. So you can make data frames even with the help of our dictionaries. Okay, like see, subjects as this and all, right? Okay. Subject maths, physics, chemistry, and the maths over there for the things, right? And as for the things you find it there. Okay, so with the dictionaries, and this can be even saved, right? You know, see if it goes with this. df. You can find the things. This can be even saved, right? If I say df to 100 crore of CSV or an Excel sheet. So I'm making in CSV would be better every time, right? So it's like a sample dot CSV data and just run this. So inside your directory, if you go here, you'll find sample.csv just done some seconds ago. If you open this, you'll find other things here. And see, and it could be downloaded, actually. So you can click here, and you can download this, and you can get the CSV version of this, and you can open it, right? So dictionaries are very important, actually, to go with the things, okay? So this is...